Coalition talks to govern dozens of hung municipalities are in full swing. The DA, the IFF, the Freedom Front Plus, the ActionSA party have made it clear they won't work with the ANC. Now, ActionSA's talks with the DA have now collapsed, and it says it won't accept the EFF's offer. 66 municipalities are hung with five metros up for grabs. Political analyst Sipho Seepe joins us now to discuss this. Sipho, thank you so much for joining us this morning. Coalition talks have been hot topic these last few weeks, but when are we going to see an end to this?
Well, first of all, the parties, there's a deadline in which there must be a discussion around the coalition and also establishment of municipalities. And I think all parties are very much aware of that. But most importantly, what one would expect is that initially there'll be that grandstanding that you would expect from political parties. But if parties then begin to start thinking about what the mandate of the municipality elections is all about, or the municipalities, they might actually start moving towards finding each other. Actually, we tend to be boxed within the ideological position of parties. Even the parties tend to do that. But if they start talking about and listening to each other, you'll find, for instance, all parties, none of them is opposed to the idea of effective and functioning municipality. None of them is opposed to the idea that there must be service delivery, because that's what the municipalities are all about. The whole, nobody is going to be opposed to the idea of running water, electricity, dealing with potholes, and also ensuring that you create an environment where business will flourish. So there are common things that the parties can agree on. Then there are issues that have to do with the allocation of budget. And parties have already put it very clear. Mashaba, for instance, have said whatever discussion that they're going to have must be centered around the notion of social justice. And if you listen to the ANC as well as the EFF, there is no question around the notion of social justice and pro-poor policies. But the issue here that comes in is first is the national politics that are taking place in Cape Town, which tend to cloud the proper discussion that should happen at the local level. But also the DA is not far off from there in terms of service delivery. That's why it has always said, where we govern, we do better. So if effectively there are common issues that they can agree on, what they would probably struggle on is around the issue of budget. So if you deal with the issue of budget and make sure that it begins to speak closely to the party's own mission, then you are going to move towards a possibility of coalition being created. The same applies to the NFP and IFP. And the voters have sent a clear message. But where the parties should not do and what they should not do, they should not try to get what they did not get through elections, where they think just because they are in power, they can dictate. So that is very important, that that balance must always be central. And other parties will be quick to remind whoever thinks that just because you are in a majority, you therefore must dictate. At the same time, the small parties must move away from the arrogance that they're kingmakers. Because if they do that, that is what opens possibilities of coalitions.
Yeah, because ultimately that also creates friction. And I think that's the big concern here with all of these coalition talks. For me, there's concern that, you know, after coalition talks, then when everything has now settled in eventually, there's still going to be this friction that, you know, these parties won't be able to work together, because ultimately they do say that they all want service delivery, you know, that to be the main priority. But I can't help but think that politics will still come in the way of that being delivered to the people.
Yeah, well, in terms of our experiences and from Nelson Mandela, as well as experience in Johannesburg, there must be, from the onset, what you call rules and terms of engagement. And two, there must also be deadlock breaking mechanism, which would be supervised, or where the leaders of parties will play an oversight role. That way, it would create the possibility of simply saying, we do expect and anticipate that there'll be problems. But those problems, there is a process of dealing with them. The biggest challenge that previous municipalities have had is that the terms and rules of engagement were never transparent and were not even known. It was on sulfur industry.